spend another almost 2 hours just to have. So that's my brain. So if you ask me what's going on in Boggy Bottom, I don't know.
Is the sentiment still holding up for going on our way?
I think the sentiment is very strong.
Where were they? They'd like to have us over here behind the desk.
Oh, that's.
Go ahead and I'll do it.
Okay. If I can get it. Nice to see you.
Let me say very, very quickly that in the 50 years that the International Earth Committee has been in existence, there are very few people who have suffered as immediately as this courageous and beautiful woman who has not only been in two of the German concentration camps, but the communist prison in 1948 as well.
But well, why don't we gather around here and do it, just so you and I will stick together in a minute. Come on over here. Well, I know the work of the Rescue Committee and what it has done in these 50 years. And I'm really honored and proud to have you here and congratulate you on these 50 years.
Well, thank you very much, sir. It has indeed done some remarkable work, saved a great many people, many of whom have become good Americans.
Yes.
Started in the days of Hitler.
Yes, I know.
Bring refugees out of Germany. We continue now with programs in Afghanistan, Southeast Asia, elsewhere. Saved a lot of lives, Mr. President.
I know.
John Whitehead, who's our president, is responsible personally for the program that the IRC is conducting along the Afghan border. He set it up.
Yeah. No, that's great. I had a little group, that group recently in here, and we were sitting around talking about those refugees.
Of Afghan refugees.
Yes.
I remember seeing in the paper that you had some here.
One of them stripped down to the waist to show me the results of the chemical warfare.
Yes. And I've seen there some horrible examples of Russian terrorism. I've seen them dropping from helicopters little toy plastic airplanes that the kids go out and pick up and explode in their hands. It's just dreadful.
Yeah. Well, the young woman, she was a tiny thing. She was a medical student at the university there, and they arrested her just because somebody handed her a leaflet. You know, and she loved it. It was a leaflet from the resistance movement. But this is awful, and it bothers me even telling it, but she was telling some of the tortures that she went through. One of them was when they called her in one day, trying to get her to talk, and she didn't have anything to talk about. All she knew was she was handed a leaflet. And they brought in a young Afghan rebel that they'd captured, just a young man, and then in front of her, just plucked his eyes out and put them on the table and says, "That's what we'll do to you."
Incidentally, I should tell you that the very lovely lady you just met with is also a member of our board.
Mrs. Claire is?
Yes,
well,
of course. Yes. Mr. President, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Good to see you.
And we very much appreciate the tape you're, Charlie Wick tells us, planning to make for us for our 50th anniversary dinner.
You do it
too. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
quite a subject matter.
My Dave's daughter.
I'm gonna stand above you all day.
I guess we're here for a signing?
Yes, sir.
Proclaiming October 2nd to 8th is, as the Home Builders Week. And I'm pleased to do it. You gentlemen represent an industry that can start a recession and can cure one.
To hear you say that at our board meeting this spring, Mr. President.
Now, Pride, Mr. Bannister, I think you get the pins.
That's right. Yes, Mr. Pride, right here.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
My pleasure. It's now official, and I'm very
happy
to do it.
On behalf of the Home Builders, I want to thank you again for signing the proclamation for Home Week, National Home Week. We look forward to it. The regulation is very important, and it's coming week of the 2nd of the 8th. We also would like to thank you again for coming to our spring board meeting to speak to the board of directors. We've created a lot of euphoria. We got a lot of builders go home and start a lot of houses.
Thank you, you're probably responsible there. We got so excited about
it. As you know, the interest rates went up about 2% over the last couple of months. And great concern now about builders. We're very concerned about the
money supply. I think Holbrooker has gotten it under control and it's down the track. And once we get rid of it, it's going to keep on. The miles rate should increase. That he's not pulling the string as happened about 3 years ago. So I'm very sure we're going to need to see some.
We hope the deficits are going to come down. We're very concerned about that. Even though there's a conflict, we notice between Secretary Treasury. We're working very hard to bring it down.
We're going to do what is good at that. I think the biggest battle is we're going to have to get more cuts in spending. If you try raising taxes, they just come up with new ideas to spend.
Well, we probably feel you're going to have to do both.
Could be passed, but would not be implemented unless certain things took place, including cuts in the spending by the Congress. And that would give you in business would be able to look in and say, well, if the situation is not this way, in other words, if the deficit is still larger than a certain percentage of gross income, then it would actually go into effect. And I don't want to emphasize, but I don't see where a tax right now could be. It's a major advantage.
We support the contingency tax. I think it's important that both issues are addressed simultaneously.
And that's also when they both have that.
Yes, I know that. And we work with you.
We were right behind
you. These were one of the ones that worked for you, Mr.
President. Mr. President.
I promise that we get $3 in cuts for every dollar of tax increase. We haven't gotten $3 in cuts.
Well, Mr. President, we have a fall board of directors meeting like in the spring, in about a week from now, so I will pass on to your message the fact that interest rates are coming down.
He said it last night.
May I quote you?
We're also under National Housing Week, with an effort on the coming government regulations on a local state level. So that's
in our industry. That's our major thrust in the Housing Week. And we've had a lot of support from the Secretary on that.
I think I told you before about my friend in California building a house.
Yep. This is a good thing. Bill Nicholson. Well, you know Bill Nicholson, of course.
I see, sir.
Yes, sir. And this is our honor.
Hey, Mr. President.
Graduate.
Honor to meet you, sir.
Well, outstanding congressional ROTC in the whole United States, Lieutenant Gibbons. This is his mother, Mrs. Gibbons, his father.
Mr. President.
Nice to see you.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. President.
So we really are.
Mr. President, would you get a picture of the lieutenant standing right in here?
Right, and then we'll get a group picture.
Thank you.
All right.
They don't use that for recruiting poster, Mr. President.
For the cavalry.
This is, you don't know what a moment this is for me, because when I was governor of California, that was back when they put me down in the office. Do you see that?
Sir, I know.
Sir, did anyone get lost down in there?
Oops.
Excuse me, sir.
President, all the university had another president for you now.
We're good.
You don't have to wear.
Texas told you it's Saturday, and we want you to think about all of them when you watch the ball.
Did I lose Texas for the party?
Oh, no, sir.
Hype the game for all of them. Hype the game.
Bill is on the board of trustees. Bill Nixon on the board of trustees.
Mr. President.
Auburn graduate, football player. They want to make sure you're aware of the game in there.
I have to tell you a little story that has to do with Auburn. This is good for all.
Well, that's all right.
Go ahead. We're very used to that.
Again, when I was governor, I was at Jackson, Mississippi. And Miss was playing Auburn that day, and Miss hadn't had a good season at all. And I was in a box with the governor of Mississippi at that game, and it was, as it will happen in football, the team that had been beaten so often was the underdog, was rising to the supreme heights and winning this game that they were supposed to win. And it was about the third quarter, and pretty definite that Miss was going to do it. It was one of those lulls in the crowd in which there was just a moment of silence. And about 14 rows behind us in the stands, two governors are sitting down there. I'd been introduced at the halftime and so forth to the governor of California. A voice came out and said, you could just hear it all over. He says, man, if they do that for him, what would they have done if John Wayne was here?
You will remember having met two of our graduates last year, Madding and Hartsfield,
yes,
and Apollo, yes. Also Auburn graduates in our engineering program.
Yes, well, I...
Well, you hang back. Well, I was going to make sure you got it right.
Thank you, sir. What about you? Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you very much, sir.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you very much.
Say yes. That's made me very happy, that bill.
Good afternoon, Mr. President. Nice to see you. May I introduce you to the Republican candidate for president of the city, for mayor of the city of Philadelphia? Forgive me, Mr.
Why don't we have a picture here behind the desk, please, then you and I maybe will sit down and look like we're working.
Okay. 10 to 11.
This three-way race seem to be more detrimental to your opponent than to you?
Well, it depends what's happening now. It's a perception problem, not a real problem. Because an independent isn't going to really have any effect. And by election day, we think we'll take a huge work to the Anderson Plunge, which you might remember.
But I was wondering, I didn't know anything about the
independent. Oh, he's a credible guy. We think we can reduce him to about 6% of the vote, which at that level he takes 3 from the opponent, 3 from us. Above that he starts to crack in large because obviously it's my major opponent is black and there's a white candidate, so maybe we tend to crack in at that point. But we think the voters of Philadelphia, and he doesn't have a base. We do have a base of 180,000 Republicans. And it's growing all the time. We're registering a lot of people. So it's right in areas where you have to do well next year. And I think have a very positive impact on the race as well. Plus, we're going to win this thing.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Okay. Wish you well.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Okay.